Hello everyone, good evening, welcome back to Chemistry CC for you. Today we are going to do the part 2 of basic organic chemistry, that is the questions from hydrocarbons. As I said before, hydrocarbons is the very basic part of organic chemistry. If you are familiar with all the reactions and types of mechanisms that occur in hydrocarbons, it is very easy for you to proceed further to the functional group chemistry in organic chemistry. As simple as that. So let's begin without wasting much time. The first question today is calcium carbide on reaction with water gives. So calcium carbide, what is the formula of calcium carbide? It is CaC2 plus water, it would be giving. Definitely one of the products should be calcium hydroxide, and the second is C2H2, which is option D, acetylene. And whenever you have questions regarding which is the primary or the reactant which gives us an ethane in the following, we can always write calcium carbide, because with its reaction with water, we'll get acetylene. Now the second question. If in a reaction CH2, double bond CH2, that is ethene is given, then reaction with hypochlorous acid, we'll get a particular product M. And then we are using a reagent R and we are getting glycol. So we need to guess the reagents. First of all, let's see what happens when ethene reacts with HOCl. What would happen? There will be OH, two different parts are there, and one will be getting attached to one of the carbon. Since this is symmetrical, we can assume one the OH would be going the C, let Cl be here and OH go here. Further, if it has to form the glycol, it should react with aqueous NaHCO3. Only then this Cl will be replaced by OH. So therefore, the combinations are correctly said only in option B, and therefore that would be our answer. So in these kinds of questions, in hydrocarbons and all, most of the times you have to practice the questions and be familiar with the reaction. It would be difficult to study the whole mechanism at certain times. You will have to just learn the product by heart, like in this case. Now the next question is one of the repeated question. When acetylene reacts with arsenic trichloride in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3, it produces. So we are given Lewisite, then chlorovinyl dichloroarsine, this is arsine, okay, then nitrobenzene, and finally both A and B, that is Lewisite and chlorovinyl dichloroarsine. The answer is option D. Now let's take a look at the reaction. The reaction would be, what is arsine trichloride is AlCl3 plus C2H2, which is the acetylene, then in presence of AlCl3, first it would be forming Cl, CH, CH, AsCl2, which is Lewisite. And this on further hydrolysis, it would be forming B, chlorovinyl dichloroarsine. So that is the answer. Both of those will be formed. This is a repeated question. And so instead of learning the structure or the reaction, just keep these two words in your mind, because it is very important. I repeat, important, and keep the words Lewisite and chlorovinyl dichloroarsine in your mind. Okay. Now we'll go to the fourth question. The fourth question is propyne and propene can be distinguished by concentrated H2SO4, Br2 in CCl4, dilute KMnO4. All these are not very useful for distinguishing alkene and alkyne, because both are unsaturated compounds. But there is a difference, that is, an alkyne is having terminal hydrogen which is acidic. Terminal hydrogen acidic, and therefore this acidic terminal hydrogen will be reacting with ammoniacal AgNO3, and therefore that would be useful for distinguishing propyne and propene. Therefore the distinguishing occurs because of the terminal acidic hydrogen present in alkyne. Okay, we have already discussed another reaction important, another question regarding the same topic in the part 1 about the terminal acidic hydrogen of of alkynes. Same is the concept that we are using here as well. Now to the fifth question. Catalyst used in the polymerization of CH triple bond CH2 cyclooctatetraene. The answer is option D, NiCN twice. It is very important reaction. Please keep this one in mind. CH triple bond CH. There will be NiCN CN2. Then at 60 degrees Celsius and 15 bar pressure, along with this, we'll be having CaC2, that is a calcium carbide, and THF as well. And what would be formed? Cyclooctatetraene. Cyclooctatetraene will be formed. And this particular reaction is known as Rappe's synthesis. Rappe's synthesis. Very important. Keep this one in mind. The reaction as well as the name and the product, everything you have to keep in mind. So from acetylene, we can form a cyclic compound, that is a cyclooctatetraene, using the catalyst NiCN twice. And this can be even useful, this particular reaction can be useful even when questions are asked from organometallics. You can already understand. Not organometallics, that is from the coordination complexes, the catalysis part. If questions come, this can be useful there as well. Next question, cyclohexane on reaction with OSO4 followed with NaHSO3 gives. This is very important question, extremely important. So the answer would be cis diode, because whenever we have OSO4 or KMnO4 oxidation, we'll be having cis diode, both KMnO4 and OSO4 as such. And in certain cases with some other reagents, there can be exception in the stereochemistry, but in this form, as such, they will be forming only cis diodes. Let's see the general reaction, what happens. Let's consider a normal, this is a alkene. This is hexene, not hexene, this is cyclohexene. Then first what happens, in OSO4, osmium oxide, tetroxide, then we'll have pyridine as well. In the first stage, the oxygen of the osmium, it will be attaching to this, and we will have double bond O, and also pyridine will be slightly linked to osmium on both sides. Pyridine would be there. Further, on reacting with NaHSO3, it will be forming cis diode. That is, I'll be writing the product here. If this is darkened, that is above the plane, then 1, 2, 3, 4. This one also will be above the plane. If the other one is below the plane, one of the OH is below the plane, the second OH also will be below the plane. So they will be in the same plane, or they will be cis diodes. Okay, understood. Now the next question, the middle oil fraction of coal tar distillation condenser. This is very important, because this is asked even in the government level examination also. Coal tar distillation, here the answer would be naphthalene. And if we are checking some details, then this mainly consists of naphthalene plus phenol mixture. Then it will be first treated with NaOH, where phenol will get dissolved. Phenol dissolves and naphthalene become insoluble. That is the distillation that happens in the middle oil fraction coal tar distillation. The naphthalene and phenol will be there. It will be treated with NaOH, and out of which phenol will be soluble and naphthalene will be insoluble. Here only naphthalene is given. If combinations are given, you have to select naphthalene and phenol together. Okay. Now the next 8th question. The next question, propane when pass through a hot iron tube at 400 degrees Celsius produces. The importance of this question is that you come to know about two things. One about the reaction, and the second about the structure of the product that is formed. The answer is mesityline. Option C, mesityline. Now let's take a look at the particular reaction. So it occurs like this. It is 3 CH3 C triple bond CH, which is propane. Then at 400 degrees Celsius in red hot Fe2, in iron tube, it will be forming mesityline. In mesityline, what would be there? There would be 3 CH3 groups. Here we have 3 CH3 groups. There will be a benzene ring and 3 CH3 groups. Very important structure. So the reaction as well as the structure of mesityline, that is important in this particular question. It gives you the advantage of knowing both these things. Now the ninth question. The number of possible alkynes with molecular formula C5H8. C5H8. The first one would be normal pentyne because we'll have 5. Let's see. We are putting triple bond here. We'll have CH, C, CH, CH2, CH2, CH3. Let's count the number of hydrogen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is 1. In the next stage, what can we do? We can shift the double bond to the second one. And that would be pent-2-ine. Let's see about that. CH triple bond should not have CH. It will be having C triple bond C. Here it will be CH3. Then CH2 and CH3. Let's count the number of hydrogen. 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2. It would be 8 again. So this is the second isomer. Now let's see what else can be done. If we again shift this into here, it makes no change. It will be again, this is pent 1 ion, this is pent 2 ion. If we again shift this, this again results in pent 2 ion only. There won't be any particular change. So this, without any side chain, these are the two possible. Now let's see with side chain what happens. Let's write 4 in a row. 2, 3, 4. Triple bond, we have CH, then CH2, CH3, and let's give the substitution here, CH3. Now let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If we are giving the substitution at this carbon, there will be only one hydrogen here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Only this is the other possible alkane with this molecular formula. So the answer would be option 3. If you want, you can check again. So what is the thing that we have to do? First of all, write the number of straight chain compounds that are possible. Then try to put one or two substitution. Here only one substitution would be possible. If we put one more, it doesn't make any sense. It will be again giving you the straight chain. Straight chain only, there won't be any difference, particular difference in the there will not be any new alkyne. The same thing will be repeating even if we do any more arrangements in this particular. So the answer would be option 3. So the answers are pent 1-9, pent 2-9 and 3-methyl-but-1-9. Okay, now the 10th question is the most important. It is one of the most important reaction for the preparation of an important organic substance. The answer here, that is, we are asking for an inorganic compound that forms an organic substance on heating. The answer is ammonium cyanate. And let's, if we look at the reaction, it will be clear for us why it is important. Ammonium cyanate is NH4NCO. On heating, we will be getting NH2CONH2, which is urea. Urea is most important, one of the most important compound in case of chemistry, organic chemistry. So urea can be prepared by simply heating this particular organic compound, which is ammonium cyanate. That's all. We'll be continuing with other videos very soon. Then keep watching. Prepare this part very well. As I have said, if you are well aware of all the reactions in hydrocarbons, it will be very helpful for you in the functional group chemistry. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching. Please keep watching the channel for more videos and hit the bell icon for latest notification. All the best for you. Ask any doubts and any videos that you want in the comment section below. It would be our pleasure to help you out. Thank you so much.